taking this opportunity for us to be part of such a grand event. So we didn't really understand what the paper thing is. And yesterday we had the privilege and also had a happy conversation. And in fact, talking about a story of what I shared to him a couple of months back. So I had started in London for a considerable period of time, and Europe is, I didn't know much about Europe, and the only thing that I was ever fascinated by was the pastries. I could see the varieties, I could see, what is the difference between going to the French side of that, area and being in the UK and other places. And I could not understand why we don't get this in India. And then slowly, steadily, I could see that, when I got opportunity to go to England or a year back to see a world competition, again, then I could see there was a lot of science behind creating the pastries, creating, there's a lot of thinking and something that's part of history. And slowly and steadily, especially what I see today, the kind of inspiration, the kind of discussions that are taking place, let's say it's at a level in which I think so we can see India also getting better in the world level to create such an experience. And the discussions today were wonderful. And I again thank Mr. Rajkapu for creating this opportunity for NSPC to be part of it. We would want to create, two discussions which I want to say we would want to strengthen on this creation of more national occupation standards for migrant-related trades, and also for food safety. Food safety is something which has been discussed multiple times. Even when we say we have approached, let's say, even the corporate citizen industry, we could trust it and say, I don't know what Maggie and Nestle incidents was and what was not. I want to interpret it. But at the same time, having regional centers that food safety can happen, having places where people can approach to really understand and probably can put tested at a local level. So this is something which was a request a lot of people came up with. So I would say, and from the road busing industry, and also people from the industry that aspirant skills that will be popular. In the back office, we will provide support at NGC. But being from the industry, you would have to, and the leaders from the industry here, you would have to take this forward. And let's see, hopefully, next time we meet, you have your examples, and that's where also to discuss. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Abhishek. And now I would like Srimati Anuradha Prasad, IES, and Joint Secretary, Ministry of Food Processing Industry, Government of India. Thank you, ma'am, for coming and joining us today.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Just a bit of correction. I'm not from the IAS, but I'm from one of the central services, so I must say that it's been a privilege to be here in the IPTM, and what I've been seeing since morning is immense positive energy, enthusiasm here. What I've seen in the displays upstairs was coming together of science, creativity, artistry. So it augurs very well, not only just for this organization, for this institution, but for the sector, that is the bakery sector, and for the larger food processing sector. So I represent the Ministry of Food Processing here. I will tell you something as to what the Ministry is doing, what the role of the Ministry is playing, and about the sector in general. The food processing sector, some of you will be reading the papers, etc., is one of the fastest growing sectors of the Indian economy. It is the bridge between the farm from agriculture to the industry, that is manufacturing, and then to the consumer. So this is the way we can make available safe food, we talk about safe, healthy food, nutritious food, at affordable prices to the consumers. And at the same time, ensure that the farmers get remunerative prices for their produce. It was mentioned that yes, we are the largest, second largest producers of wheat in the world. We are one of the big raw material, agricultural raw material bases of the world. In terms of, we are one of the largest grain producers in the world. We are also the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world. We are the largest producer of milk in the world. But a large part of our produce gets wasted because we are not processing. So what happens is what the farmer produces, so whenever there is excess, there is a price flat, a large part of the produce just gets wasted on the field itself. Some of it gets wasted during the transportation because of lack of storage facilities and so on. So the Ministry, what they're trying is their support is towards to bring down these wastage through supply chain infrastructure, through cold storages, through food parks, food promote processing, etc. So to just bring down the wastage and to ensure that the consumers get food which is healthy and safe and nutritious. So we are also supporting in terms of the food safety part, we are supporting food testing labs, which and there is now a big requirement for food testing labs because of the food safety law bill which is coming in force and which is now getting implemented with lot of vigor and strictness by the FSSAI. So we and not only food testing labs, but we are also giving support to the units, and many of them are small units for implementation of HACCP and ISO 22000 and other food safety management systems. So we give support to the units for that also.